ear speaker not working on iPhone after the iOS 17 update. How's it going, everyone? This is Akash and welcome back to the SkyTech Studio. Today's video, I'll show you how you can fix your ear speaker stopped working after the recent iOS 17 update. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video and fix the problem. Well, so now to fix the problem, before you do anything, make sure to turn off your ringer volume to the upper level and then go ahead and take your issue. And later on, simply head over to settings and then scroll down and tap on accessibility, and then scroll down again, tap on touch, and from here you need to scroll down again and you'll get to see the option call audio routing. Go ahead and tap on that, and if it's selected to the automatic, be sure to select it to the speaker, or if it's selected to the speaker, go ahead and select it to the automatic. And after that, just get back to your home page and then restart or turn off and on your iPhone once. And once you restarted your iPhone, hopefully your problem is going to be solved. But if you're still having the problem, then the very next thing that you have to do, you need to clean up your ear speakers. Go ahead and take a soft brush and clean your ear speaker very gently, because sometimes the dust and particle can stuck in the ear speaker and you can have this kind of problem. And let's say you did this process, but if you're still having the problem, then the next thing that you gotta do, all you have to do is simply go ahead and open up the settings once again and then scroll down, tap on general, and then tap on software update. And if you find any pending update available, go ahead and update your iPhone as soon as possible. But if you don't find any update, get back from here, then scroll down and tap on transfer reset iPhone, tap reset, tap reset all settings, and then put your password right here. Now go ahead and tap on reset all settings again, but make sure this will reset all of your settings and it will get back to the default. So be sure to remember your Wi-Fi password and other settings. And after doing this process, your phone is going to take a restart, and once you get back, hopefully your problem is going to be solved. Well, so after following all of this process, if you found that you are still having the problem, then all you can do is just go ahead and contact with Apple support for further assistance. So guys, hope you find this pretty helpful. If you do, drop a like and subscribe to this channel. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.